I got a request that I make a journal page and record it and narrate it, so I'm going to give it a shot today. Seems like a good idea. First off, let me apologize if you hear my dogs bark. My doggies live in the same room as my studio space is, so sometimes they get noisy and I apologize. And I have baby birds right outside my window in the eave of my house, and sometimes the mama bird yells at something out there. So if you hear a really loud bird, I apologize. Okay, so what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna work in my handmade art journal. I threw this together pretty quickly, actually. The outside cover is a file folder, like for a hanging file folder to hold the folders that go in your drawer. That's what it's made out of. It's got four signatures in it. I use duct tape on the outside edge to just reinforce it because I think these printed duct tapes are just super cute. I did do a video on making this art journal, which I have not put up yet. I have no real idea what I want to do today. You've seen some of these pages that I've posted. It's brand new. I just started with it. If you subscribe to my blog, if not, you can check it out. It's ClaudiaRossiStudios.com, and pretty much everything that I do ends up there, so you can check it out. But these are just, you know, just got started. But I put this together just with a mess of different pages. This is where I clean my stamps and stuff. So I have this, and I think I want to work on a certain page that I have here. Let me see. And I work front and back towards the middle. Just kind of something that I'm doing because I like, there's a doggy. I don't like when you get to the end of an art journal and this is all thick and full and the page just will not lay down. So I started from the back and I started from the front, and I'll work with my way to the middle so it will lay while I'm trying to work on it. So I'm not really particular about following the dates and keeping it in order of when I made it. It's just not that important to me. So I go ahead and work that way. I decided to work on this page here. I like this little inclusion that it has right here. I thought it'd be fun. When I tore apart my mixed media pages to put in the book, I ended up with some little pieces. So I decided to just throw them in there and see what happened. I watched a lot of videos from Donna Downey. I like her. She's amazing. She always has these cute little inclusions, and I decided I was going to throw some in and give it a shot and use my scraps. This is printed on. It's because it's a printed paper is one of my pages that I get. It came in Somerset Studios magazine. They almost always have some art journaling papers in there for you, some artist papers, usually four or so. And so it's printed on the back with who made it and all. So I stuck that in there. It's like a perfect pre-made background, right? So what I'm gonna do, I have no idea yet what I'm gonna do on this page. I'm gonna start with gessoing my pages. Because, oh, look, Mama Bird, I'm sure you can hear her. She is louder than loud. I'm going to tape the creases of my book because I don't know what I'm doing yet. And sometimes I get really, really sloppy and messy. And I don't want the inks or the paints or water, whatever that I put through, I don't want it to run through to the next pages. I'm gonna go ahead and gesso these pages and then I'll come back. Okay, so I have gesso on these pages. It's still wet. I just wanted to stop and show you something that I'm doing that I think is really fun. I just like the way it turns out. So what I'm doing is the pages are still kind of wet, so I'm gonna push them together before I dry them and then pull them apart, and I I'm just in love with this texture. Oh, that was not a good idea. Look, I uncovered the words. I guess it's not gonna work on this one. It will work on the other side though, so it'll be okay. Let's put a little bit more gesso out there, and I'll paint that in a minute. But can you see the texture? I hope you can see the texture that it adds. It's just kind of neat. It's real subtle, but it just pulls apart and it leaves just this little bit of texture. Let me see. We can zoom in if you can see it. Oh, that's not working. Okay, let's try moving the book. Okay, there we go. Can you see that texture that just ends up on those pages? It's not much. I mean, it's not thick or deep or anything. It's just kind of interesting, and I kind of like it. So I'm going to finish painting over my words again, and then I will dry this, and then I will be back. And I'm going to use... I'm so rough on my brushes. I'm terrible to them. Oh, this one, like, it comes apart. Like, I'm bad. I'm very, very bad. But I want to really scrub the paint in, which I do all the time. So I figure, you know, I'll just buy more brushes because that's how it goes. What I'm using are Lumiere paints. I absolutely love these things. I am using the pearlescent blue and the citrine green. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to really spread the paint around. Okay, this is Taylor Downey FW Artist Acrylic Ink, or Acrylic Artist Ink, and it is in Process Magenta. Just shake these really good because the color tends to settle on the bottom. So, just randomly, I am going to add some ink to these pages. Look, I have color. Woohoo! I like. I'm gonna let this dry, or, well, I'm going to dry this with my heat gun, and then I will be back. Can you see that shimmer? Oh, it's fantastic. I don't know if you can see this like I can, but it's so great. I'll be right back. Okay, I lied. I'm not gonna dry this. Since I have to dry it anyways, what I'm gonna do is go ahead and do my letter stenciling that I want to do on here. It's just a letter stencil, and then I'm going to spray through it with this Java Antiquing Solution. Greatest stuff. It is water soluble, so afterwards I will have to spray it with a fixative, or it will come up with the things if I paint over it or rub on it very hard. Okay, somehow I didn't record that I needed to dry the one side so I could flip the inclusion over and then stamp the left side, and now I'm gonna dry the whole thing and I'll be back when it's all dry. Okay, here I am just determining where I want to place my scraps of tissue paper, and then I'm going to adhere them using matte medium that I'm just gonna brush on. And this tissue paper is by Tim Holtz, comes on a roll like wax paper, and it's really great. I like how with the tissue paper, it's so sheer once it's glued down that you can still see the letters that I stamped through on the page coming through that tissue paper right there. You can see it. And I'm not really going to stick with this dictionary definition. I just like the text being down there. I'm going to cover up most of it later because it doesn't really relate to what I'm going to put on the page, a quote that I have printed out. So we'll be changing that later. Okay, I'm just going to finish this up and then I'll be back. Camera's wobbling. Hi, I'm back. Okay, so this is dry. Very, very dry. I have a confession to make. I have been out of my studio and away from my journal for probably 2 months. It gets really, really hot out here because there's no air conditioning in this part of the house. So when it's 110, 115 outside, I can't be out here. I can't stand it. I'm a big wimp and I don't like to be hot. So I hide inside my house in front of a fan. So I know I had plans for this page, and I have some things that I had tucked away inside of it so that I didn't forget everything completely. But I know that I made some assumptions as to how this page was going to go before I left you last, and it may or may not go in that same exact direction. I'm not really sure, but we'll find out as we go. I really like the way this looks right now, but it's kind of dark, and I want to use this tag, and it's kind of dark, and so I want to get a little white basically back in the page. So I am going to use Golden Zinc White. It is a little bit translucent, more so than their regular titanium white. I'm going to use the zinc white because the titanium white is more opaque and the zinc white is more translucent, and I don't want to completely cover over everything that I did. I just want to get a little bit of white back in here so I can add some bright colors. So what I'm doing is I just spread, you can't see that, I just spread a little bit of paint on a disposable palette, and I'm going to run my brayer through it and pick up the paint on my brayer and then run that across my page. Lightly. This is done very lightly. You don't want to use a heavy hand or you're going to cover everything. And that's not the goal. I just want to get a little going on here. Do you hear the sniffles? I can't get away from them. I'm so sorry. I am still recovering from my cold, and I'm trying so hard not to make those disgusting noises for you on camera, but I seem to be unable to stop myself, and I'm sorry. You can tell as I roll this on. Oop, no, I don't want to cover that butterfly. Well, soon to be butterfly. Yeah, do that. Okay. You can tell a lot more of the texture that I had talked about before when you push the gessoed pages together, and how it leaves just a slight texture. Now that I'm putting the white paint over top of it, you can see more clearly where the texture lied. Let's get that closer so you can see more exactly like how the texture looks when you press those pages together and then let them loose. These are just my guard pages so that I don't mess up the rest of the journal when I do this stuff. I want to rub this around just a little bit because I don't love seeing that texture so much, but I do like the white on there. So I'm going to kind of work back and forth with the brayer and maybe the tissue. It's just a dry paper towel. I want a little bit more control over where I put some of it, so I'm going to use my Portfolio oil pastels. These are water-soluble oil pastels, so they're fun. They're very creamy. They're like a crayon that you can manipulate either with water. But most of the time, whenever I use these, I use my fingers because they're so soft, and as you warm them with your hand on the page, they move so great. So, like, I don't know if you can just see like how easy it is to move this around with just your fingers and just smush it. Very technical terms that I use. And I could do this with paint and a paintbrush if I wanted to, but this is kind of fun. So we're going with it. And again, this is water soluble, so it will move later when I apply other layers or any other media or water, even after I've rubbed it. If I apply anything watery on top of this. It does have the ability to move a little, and that could be a good thing, could be a bad thing, depends on what you're doing. Just be aware of that. What I'm getting out now is my black Derwent ink pencil. These are Derwent, can you read that? Derwent ink tense pencils. Basically, they go on dry like a colored pencil, and then when you get them wet, they turn into vivid ink. So these are water soluble as well. So these are more water soluble than the oil pastels though. So we're gonna see if I can manipulate that without completely obliterating my colors. So I have a little jar that I fill. It's gross. I never wash anything. With just a little bit of water so that I have clean-ish water to use for these type things, and then just gonna move just that black around a little. Now, the cool things about the ink tense pencils is that even though they are water soluble when you draw them on, once you get them wet, once you get them wet and they dry again, then they dry impermeable. So then you can work right on top of them once they're dry and it won't matter, it's not going anywhere. So those are really fun to work with if you haven't had the chance. It's worth it. Buy a few in the colors that you like. You don't have to buy a whole set. They can tend to be kind of expensive. I buy a few at a time until I ended up with my little collection that I have here. But I only bought them a few at a time. There's no reason to spend, too much money on art supplies all at once. You'll find I have no plan most of the time when I start these pages, or even as I'm doing them, I don't always have a plan as to what I want to get done, what I want to accomplish. I just start doing it and, see what happens. Sometimes I end up covering up everything that I do. People asked, why do you put this down and that down and then cover it up with something else? Sometimes it just works out that way. It's just part of the process of getting to where I want to be. So I don't always know what I'm doing when I get started. I might have a loose general plan, but I don't always have a real solid plan. It's just kind of the way I am. Okay. You don't have to tell anybody that you don't have a plan or that you didn't have any idea what you were going to do when you started. Like, it's not necessary to tell on yourself. You can just do what you want, and if it comes out beautiful, then you can Just let people think that's exactly what you had planned from the start, right? Okay, and back to the oil pastels, because I wanted the smudginess of them. Honestly, if you've never used these things, you need to get some. Like, race out the door right now and get some. Ooh, I don't like that. Too much. Great thing about these, a little too much comes right off. Okay, so these, not expensive. Not at all. I mean, I think you can pick them up at Walmart. definitely at Michael's or any other standard craft store. There's no... They're not expensive at all. I mean, I would definitely say under $10 for this set. Excuse me. So, well worth it if you like to. And this is a whole set. So, I'm spilling them. Okay. This is a box set. And so I'm going to have, what, probably, I don't know, 20 colors maybe? Okay, I'm using just a little bit of quinacridone magenta. I want to go ahead and color in my butterfly now. Okay, I dried it a little bit, what I could, because you have to be careful. You can see, I don't know if you can see right here, where, oh, camera shake, earthquake. Okay, right here where I got the oil pastels, too hot with my heat gun. So, like, if you touch them, it's going to come off. I want to get these words on here. So I'm going to cut these out. Okay, I have these Tim Holtz stamps. Can they get any better? Like, stamps, yay. So, I'm going to use this one that says, live the life you've imagined. I didn't know. I don't even think you even saw what happened. So I guess the live the life you've imagined was attached to this umbrella guy right here. I didn't know that. I thought it was separate, so I just pulled it off, tore it. We'll see what happens. So I tried the stamp in a couple of places, and it just didn't show up. Maybe the ticket. Maybe I should have stamped that on the ticket. Oh, you couldn't see it now! Hooray! That makes me happy because I really like this ticket and I really like the stamp, and now they're both going to make it on my page where they belong. I'm retarded. I can't get the stamps back together. I am working on it. I need a way to store these things. I know, like, there's people out there who have these wonderful binders, these fancy binders full of all of their clean stamps. And I want one really bad, but I haven't done it. I haven't taken the time to look it up and find one on YouTube. But I'm going to. I'm determined. I'll be right back. I need purple. Oh, by the way, those of you who like products, I'm sorry, I haven't been showing them. Stays on jet black. That's the color I used for the stamp. Stays on royal purple is what I used for the edges. I'm bad about this. Okay. So, light purple paint, this is Brilliant Purple by Basics, cheap Liquitex brand Basics student paints. My doggies have been really good so far while I've been recording, but they are now like right outside the sliding glass door, and the door is open, and I have a feeling you'll be hearing them soon. So I apologize. I'll probably have to apologize in every video for my doggies because they live where I paint. So I use soft gel medium, which mine is not very soft anymore because, as you can see, it's almost gone. So it's getting thick and hard, and I'm determined to use the last of it though, and then I'm going to do my best to scrape out what's left so that I can use this jar again because it's a nice size. I have a huge bucket, well, not bucket, but a huge jar of it, many more ounces. And it's too big to keep on my table all the time, and I don't want to open it all the time and have it get dried out. So I have my little one, and I'm going to refill my 8 ounce from my big. I think it's like a 32 ounce. So yeah, I washed my brush, and I need to use it again. I found in my stuff while I was looking around this cute little bird that I'm gonna stick on here, right there. It's a Kay & Company. I buy these little packs of many, many die cuts, and I get flowers and I get butterflies and all this stuff in them. So they're lots of fun. Maybe while this dries, I'll show you the packs, and I'll show you how I store them. While we wait for that to dry, I'm going to get you my book. I'm going to show you. It's a big mess. Let me zoom out. Oops, wrong way. Okay, it's kind of a big mess. It's not a mess. It's actually organized. It's just big. It's dusty. Everything's dusty out here. But it's basically where I keep all of my flat things, rub-ons and stickers that I know I want to use. I have a huge sticker binder for my scrapbooking stuff, and I don't use a lot of that in my art, or I pulled out a lot of the ones I thought I would, and then I know I can go over there and get them. It's way too much to just have at my disposal all the time. It's huge. It's a big sticker binder. So I got this. What it is it's just a little three ring binder. It's a small size. And I bought, let's flip to the back. I bought these pockets from just the office supply store. I think all this came from Office Max. So I bought sets of pockets, and they come with, I don't know, four or five. Looks like four or five. Five different colors in a set. I don't know how many sets I bought. But just these little pockets that I store everything in. And then I bought these things. These are really cool. This is actually a stick-on. This didn't come on the binder. I bought it separate. It's really stuck. I can't remember if this is from Post-it, like sticky notes Post-it, or if it's somebody else. I can't remember, but I got it there. And it's just a little envelope, and I keep whatever. But right now I just have this one set of different chipboard things on it. So I keep those in there. And then I keep my stickers. This one's already used, so I need to put more. I keep my stickers and my rub-ons, and I put one in each direction because you can pretty much see through this. I mean, I don't need the colors. So that's, I keep my stickers, and then I have a few of these little cutouts, die cuts, and they're not really die cuts, they're just cutouts of a piece of scrapbooking paper that had all these little journaling cards on it. So I have those, and just a bunch of little things, a little dolphin sticker that I made. Oh, see, there's the doggies. You hear them? They're barking. But this little dolphin sticker I made out of micro beads and chalk and just stuff. I have some dried flowers. Shh, shh, shh. Hush Puppy. And just some little things that I threw together back when I was card making. Do you hear them? You hear them? They're fighting. Oof. So, lots of stickers, rub-ons, basically. So I have all of these in here. So this just helps me. It's huge and it sits on a shelf. It's really tall because everything sticks out the top, but, you know. But it works for me. And I'm able to keep things together. And then I always find, and I love, like, in the dollar bins at Michael's or Joann's. So if I find something I like, I'll get a few of the same one. Because I'm going to use them in different ways anyway, so it doesn't matter if they're the same rub-ons. So if I find them cheap and I like them, I buy these little dollar Studio 112 at Joann's, and they're out of the dollar bins. I buy these letters, and I buy these stickers, and these all the time. That way, if I stick them on there and paint over them, it doesn't matter, they were cheap. I actually found this stuff at a thrift store, and they're like partially used stickers with some words left on them. Well, I can find a use for those, so I have a whole bunch of those. A couple little embellishments. I don't usually keep the three-dimensional stuff in here, but these ones just kind of ended up in there because that's where I was putting things away. And then in the back, I have just cardstock. Is all this is. It's just a piece of cardstock that I punched holes in, and then these little envelopes are by Post-it, and so they are repositionable, although I've never repositioned them, and they've just stayed on here, and these are pockets that I used to store. Now here's my K & Company. This is one set. You get all of this for a few dollars. It's great, and there's just all kinds of little bees and flowers and nests and birds and butterflies. So I have all these little K & Company things, and they stay nice and secure inside my little envelopes. This is a different set. So, and then these are some more. These are like tags. Tags and stuff. So, there you go. And that's it. I have a couple of big ones that just won't fit inside the pockets in the back pocket. This is part of the folder in the back pocket that are too wide this way to fit inside my sleeves, so I have a few sets of stickers that I like. But that's how I store all my little junk, you know, my flat stuff. It doesn't close, not even close, so it just sits on the shelf like that, or I lay it down on the shelf. But that's how it is. So anyways, if you weren't entirely bored and didn't fast forward, we'll get back to our painting. Okay, so this is still very wet, so I can't really do a lot with it, but I want to work on this other side, and I just wanted it to be safe to touch so that it didn't have problems. And then what I'm going to do here, excuse me, get my Inktense pencils back out, and I want a little color on these words. I'm gonna take the black. I'm gonna turn this upside down. Oh look, I forgot to zoom back in. Here we go. Too far. Do you hear my sick daughter coughing in the background? I don't know if you can hear that. I hope not, but she is. Okay, so let's flip this upside down so I don't have to put my hand on that. And I wanna just go around the outside. Okay, now I'm going to take my, you can read that, it says General's Layout. It's an extra black pencil, basically, graphite. So, and just go around the letters real quick. Okay, so that's very messy. Now, I'm going to take a little distress ink. Which one do I want to do? I think I want to do... I'm going to use the tea dye in the way I want it to, so let's just do this. There we go. Look what I did. I ripped it up. I'll have to glue that down. kind of like that. I did that though. I like how grungy that's making them look. That's good. Kind of want to like work on some other ones, scratch them up. Can you hear my dogs running around like crazy things out there? They're nuts. I don't know what to say. Let's go ahead and grungy up our bird just a little. Okay. I want to take an ink pen to this, but it's not dry. And it will ruin my Sharpie if I take my Sharpie to this and the medium is not dry. Like, ruin it. It will quit. They just quit writing. I ruin Sharpies all the time. I don't know how I manage to do that, but I do. Ruin them. Always. I forgot I wanted to get some ink on this one, too. I want some right there. Okay. There we go. Better. Better, better, better. As you can tell, like I told you, I don't plan anything. I never have anything well thought out when I start these things, so things just kind of happen. I'm deciding at this point. I might be done. I think I'm happy. I think I'm going to put some fresh matte medium on that, but other than that, I think I like it. How am I gonna photograph this? This is not gonna be easy. Well, there you have it. Finished journal page. I will, because this is, remember, this is oil pastels, the water-soluble oil pastels. I will take this out into my garage, and I will spray it with a really good fixative. I haven't found one that works well indoors. I've tried this. This is Spectra Fix Pastel Fixative, and it's an all-natural, it's like a protein spray, basically, and it's non-toxic. So, see? Health safe, it says right there. So, you can spray that inside and not kill yourself, but it hasn't been perfect, and I haven't had very much success. It's still full, and I'm afraid to try it, because every time I want to give it another try, I know it's going to mess up my page, and I'm going to get it wet, and it's not going to work. So I will take this outside, and I will spray it with my regular Krylon workable fixative that I always use, and then I'll probably come back in after that and rub it with turtle wax after it's fully dry and cured. Rub it with turtle wax so that the pages don't stick when they're dry. But definitely with this water-soluble mediums all over it. I mean, I have the ink and I have pencil. Well, the ink isn't, but I have the oil pastels all over this whole page. It has to be, absolutely has to be sealed and protected. So I will spray this later and then put turtle wax. So don't think I'm just going to leave it, because as you can tell, it is rubbing off on my fingers as we speak. So good day to you all. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm glad to have finally finished this. I have a couple more things coming up. I was sick for a while, so I had some time, and I spent it working on backgrounds, mostly, you know, things like this to get going, just to get started. I was sick and sitting on my couch, so I did a couple of sketches, and I did a couple of backgrounds. So I just have some blank things to get started with when I have more time to record. So I will work on that and see you guys soon. Thanks for watching.